Hello and welcome to episode number 23 of WITM Season 6. And it's finally pay-per-view time once again. This time it's time for NXT TakeOver In Your House, our first NXT pay-per-view of WITM Season 6. And it features six matches on the card, three of which will be featured WITM matches. The first one is the one you see on your screen, where for the final time, the Generation will be competing as a stable before they part and go on in their separate ways. They'll be represented by the leader of the Generation, Aaron Danger, tagging with the debuting Matt Olson, a new WITM member that you may remember from WITM the prequel as part of the Generation. In Chapter 3 of the prequel, Matt Olson. And they will be accompanied by Rose, the NXT Women's Champion, who will be competing in a match of her own later tonight. Their opponents, a team that they invited over from SmackDown as part of the Cross-Brand Invitational, the Legion. They'll be represented by the dual Intercontinental and 24/7 Champion, Aiyot Master, as well as one half of the SmackDown Tag Team Champions, and a former member of the Generation himself, Zims. And managed by the leader of the Generation and the other half of SmackDown Tag Team Champions, Corey. Then, Andrew Spudstrong, arguably the face of WITM during his first five seasons, is finally making his in-ring return, where he will defend the NXT Cruiserweight title he is in the middle of his seventh reign with, against the winner of the number one contenders tournament, Isaiah Swerve Scott. And in the main event, Rose will defend her NXT Women's Championship against her rival, the Queen, Charlotte Flair. Obviously, the winner of the match will be NXT Women's Champion. The loser will leave NXT for good, and this match is a no-holds-barred matchup. Absolutely anything goes. But our first match will be the Generation taking on the Legion. Aaron Danger has history with both of the men he'll be competing against. He chased Aiyot Master prior to Aiyot Master's call-up to SmackDown for months over the North American title, and Aiyot Master always got the best of him, so Danger will be looking for revenge here. And then Zims, a member of the Generation since day one, turned his back on Aaron Danger on our first NXT episode of Season 6. And left the Generation in order to join Corey's Legion. Matt Olson, an original member of the Generation, back in the Generation to compete in their final match as a stable, as well as making his WWE and NXT debut. And of course, the Legion would love to spoil the farewell match of the Generation. Prior to the match, we're going to have a little video package highlighting some of the build-up to this matchup that I just mentioned. And then, following that, we'll get straight into the entrances and then the match. Enjoy. The following. Zims, I challenge you to face two people you stabbed in the back, in our house, NXT, at NXT TakeOver In Your House in a week and a half. For a match, thou'll see myself in the debuting Matt Olson, an original member of the Generation, with your girlfriend and the reigning NXT Women's Champion Rose watching at ringside, versus you, and that painted-up freak Aiyot Master with your fat, beep, leader Corey watching at ringside as we decimate his Legion. And what will be the Generation's last stand and statement as a stable. And Zims, if you think you're broken now, Just wait until I get my hands on you. See you in 10 days, if you have the guts. I will then tag with Zims, with Corey watching at ringside at NXT TakeOver in your house, when we officially brand the generation a forgotten footnote in WWE history. And let me just say, I personally cannot wait to put an end to the generation once and for all. And as if I needed a good reason to do what I did to Aaron Danger and turn my back on the generation and join the Legion, let me remind you that I became one half of the SmackDown Tag Team Champions after just 2 matches with the Legion, and in 9 days of backlash, I'll have an opportunity to become the Universal Champion. Compare that to my time with the generation, where we accomplished absolutely nothing in NXT under Aaron Danger, who still can't win the big one to this day. Legion, tonight we took over your house. This Sunday, we'll see you in ours.
Coming swiftly, the border's closing in. We're a company of soldiers, near 40 rifles strong. All alone.
The following contest.
Stand alone. The and then the guns burning, and rumble this expand. As the blitzkrieg's pushing harder, the war is all around. Fighting, the numbers will still count. We're outgunned and few in numbers. We're doomed to flag or fail. We fought hard, held our guard. But when captured by the excess and forced to tell the truth, we will tell it with a smile. We will surprise them with a laugh. We are on. We were on.
Cause we are all inside. We take up hearts and
All right, well, that generation entrance, the final generation entrance ever, was a cluster beep of glitches. But anyway, let's not let us distract from this, what should be great, grudge match between the generation and the Legion, the final match ever for the generation as a stable, and the in-ring debut of Matt Olsen. Can they pull off an upset here in their final match together and defeat the Legion, who has dominated the landscape of SmackDown Live, holding every title available to men at the moment, other than the Universal title currently held by Casey, which the Legion will try to capture next Sunday at Backlash. Ayat Master starts things off for the Legion. The leader of the generation, Aaron Danger, started things off for the generation, but now here we go. This is what we've been waiting to see. Zims, the man who turned his back on the generation and Aaron Danger, going head to head with his former leader, Aaron Danger. Zims, a member of the generation since day one, probably the most successful member of the generation, now fighting against them in the generation's final match together, but Danger won't last long in the ring with Zims. Here is the in-ring debut,
it's not going to be easy though, Michael.
At least in the WWE, of Matt Olsen, our newest WITM member.
And he gets there.
Right now it is Zims firmly in control and the Legion in control. And now here comes the powerhouse, the dual Intercontinental and 24/7 champion, Ayat Master, the legal man for the Legion. The man who's been a thorn in Aaron Danger's side since day one. On Aaron Danger's very first night as part of the NXT roster, he faced Ayat Master at a takeover for the NXT North American title that Ayat Master held at the time. And Master remained the North American champion. He has been a thorn in Aaron Danger's side ever since. And now Master continues to be a thorn in Aaron Danger's side as he is dismantling his tag team partner, Matt Olsen. The Legion is firmly in control early on in this matchup, but here comes Zims. Now Olsen getting some offense in, going for a, I believe, a power bomb. And planting the face of Zims right into his own corner on the top turnbuckle. Now Olsen trying to turn momentum into the generation's favor and quickly gets back into the ring following that apron attack before Ayat Master can get a hold of him. Momentum wise, if you look at the HUD, the generation are now in control. And now it's a double team attack. A Hurricane Rana into a power bomb.
A much needed tag here. And if successful, we may be looking at a whole new match here. Looks like we're gonna get the tag.
Great suplex from Aaron Danger.
Running on fumes right now.
As we see Danger versus Zims again, but not for long. Here comes the man that Danger lost to in a title match on his first night as part of the WWE roster, Ayat Master. I'm sure Danger would absolutely love to pin Ayat Master in his final night as leader of the generation. There's a drop kick, but it barely even stirs Ayat Master. He connects with a massive clothesline, but is going to lead to a rope break. However, Danger's head is now in the yellow zone. Danger does, however, have a signature maneuver in his arsenal, but first he'd have to get on the attack. Right now is Master in control, using the ropes to attack Danger and send his body into the yellow zone now as well. Now Master with a massive suplex that causes Danger to get caught between the bottom and middle ropes. Now Master attacking the legs of Danger. He wants every part of Danger's body to be in pain. Master absolutely loves to inflict pain and he goes for cover, but Danger powers out almost immediately. Now here comes Zims. We're going to get to see Zims and Aaron Danger head to head once again. Zims believes that he likely should have been the leader of the generation, and claims that he is the man that the WWE higher up saw the most potential in, but Danger stole that opportunity from him. Matt Olson, now the illegal man for the generation, sends Zims' head into the yellow zone. And now Zims' body is in the yellow zone as well, after he got launched halfway across the ring by Olson. Now Olson trying to get the support of the NXT universe, as Zim seems to be in a pretty bad way, very slow to get up. But now Olson will go back on the attack. By the way, whoever made this arena, I love this old school look. This is a pretty good looking arena for this pay-per-view. And Master, now the legal man, and he just goes straight into a cover, but Olson's going to power out at one. There's a reverse backbreaker from Master. Of course, the Legion have another huge tag team match next week, where both their SmackDown tag team titles and Captain Casey's Universal title will be on the line. So, of course, they want to bring as much momentum into that match as they can. That would mean getting a win here tonight, though there is no title on the line, or really, the titles are not on the line tonight. They still want to bring as much momentum in as they can in that huge matchup next week at Backlash. Master tags himself into this matchup and goes after Aaron Danger with a massive suplex that caused him to get caught on the ropes again. Zims, who the non-legal man for the Legion, is still trying to recover. Zims has been very slow to recover from offense as of late. He may have suffered some sort of injury. Aaron Danger starting to get in danger of an injury as well, with his body now in the orange zone, but he is on the attack and has a finisher stored. Now Danger starting to get fired up as AI Master heads to the apron to try to recover.
Oh my God, guys. Look at this.
Danger with a power bomb from the apron to AI Master. Great move there by Danger, not giving Master the chance to recover. And now they fight on the outside. Please don't let this lead to a count out. This has been a great match. It would be a real shame to see it in that manner. Now Danger in danger, no pun intended, of injury, as Master is sent into that steel barricade. Danger seems content to get the count out victory here, but changes his mind to literally the last second and decides to go back in the attack, as Corey, the leader of the Legion, watches very closely as Master gets attacked. Now it's Danger sent into the steel barricade. Barricade is shattered. Master spearing Danger into that steel barricade, almost taking out that little girl there in the first row. Now it's Master in the ring. We'll see if he decides to take the count out victory or break the count. He will break the count. And goes back after Aaron Danger, who is in a very bad way health-wise, and might want to think about getting back into the ring as soon as possible, making a tag to the completely uninjured Matt Olson. Danger elects to continue to go on the attack and connects with the ripped cord knee slash one winged angel to Master, and very nearly pulls off the upset win for the generation. But Master powers out at 2.5, and now ripping the entire face of Danger is a up Master, but he is able to break that hole, and there's a kick to the back. Now Danger forces Master to his feet. Master's in a pretty bad way now himself, health-wise. Body in the orange and head in the yellow.
If he could just make it to his corner, these guys still have a chance.
Seems like the strategy for the generation is to have Aaron Danger inflict as much damage as possible, and then maybe later in the match bring in a healthy Matt Olsen to take on two tired members of the Legion. And Master is going to make the Mercy tag to Zims. Aaron Danger versus Zims once again. Definitely would be nice to see these two men also face each other in a singles match down the line. But now we get some sort of a preview of that within a tag team matchup. Danger with a kick to the gut of Zims goes for a clothesline, but it's going to be reversed by Zims, who connects with a suplex of his own. Danger now has two body parts in the red zone. If he takes, can't take a whole lot more damage without being added to the injured list, as Zims now taunts his opponent. And you can see Danger very slow to get up, on the verge of injury, and Zims may be inflicting it right here. Massive DDT goes into a cover, and Danger somehow, even with all that damage he's taken, is going to power out at two. There's an elbow to the head of Danger from Zims, who is very much fired up and looking for or their heels, but they can't really get the support of the NXT Universe, but looking to antagonize his opponents. But here comes Danger with a super kick to the head of Zims. Danger goes for cover, and it's going to be broken up in just a nick of time by AI Master, who made it back to the ring to break up that cover just in time. There's another ripcord knee from Danger, who goes for cover. Very nearly a victory for the Generation, but again, AI Master there just in time to make the save, and we have utter chaos with all four men in the ring. Danger and Zims are the legal man. There's an enziguri from Danger. Zims now in danger of an injury, which would be very, very bad for the Legion, as Zims is supposed to compete in that huge winner-takes-all tag team match in 1 week at Backlash. Now Zims looking to take flight here, connects with the diving elbow drop, and now Zims looking to finish this with a finisher. And that connects. Zims goes for cover. Broken up at 2.5 by Matt Olsen, who still is very, very healthy. But Danger, for some reason, wants to do this on his own. Of course, this is a very personal grudge match for Danger, who very much dislikes both AI Master and Zims. Now Zims with a submission locked in, single leg Boston Crab. That's going to be broken up by Danger. Airship into the ropes from Danger and a swinging neck breaker.
Really needs to get to the corner and make a tag. Otherwise, this match may be
Danger actually using one of Corey's taunts there to taunt Zims, maybe sending a message to the Legion. Both these men in this ring right now, very much in a bad way health-wise, but you can't tell by how hard they are fighting. But Zim's very slow to get up here, now forced up by Danger. Danger kick connects. Is this going to lead to a Generation victory? No, broke up at 2.5 by AOP Master. What a great tag team war we have going on. This is just the first of three huge matches on this pay-per-view card. What a great opening match. Danger and Zims still the legal man, as they have been for a while. Zims with a clothesline sends Danger on the outside. He can Danger in, again, no pun intended, massive danger here. Zims could easily put him into the purple zone, which would make Danger officially injured here on the outside. But it is Danger on the attack. Super kick from Zims, who's again taunting his opponents as he's done frequently in this matchup. Suplex. And massive setup powerbomb by Zims. Danger sent on the outside as Zims heads back in. Please tell me he's going to break the count. Yes, he does. Both these teams could have easily taken a count out victory, but they are choosing to win this match via a definitive decision, pinfall or submission. Danger now getting fired up as he has laid out Zims and now sends him into the apron and ring post. Repeatedly, looks like he's trying to send Zims' head into the purple zone and officially injure him. Now Zims returning the favor, and he will once again break the count rather than taking the count out victory. Now they continue to fight on the outside. And now it's Danger repeatedly sent into the apron and ring post once again. Danger returning the favor to Zims, who connects with a reversal. There's a reversal by Danger. Zims sent crashing into his leader, Corey. Danger says, that's the leader you want to serve right now. There you go. You can have him. Now, once again, we are in danger of a count out as Zim sends Danger into the steel steps. And, of freaking course, this match ends in a double count. Okay, so this match has been restarted with a little bit of a different rule set. This time, disqualifications are off. No countouts, and just simulates most of the damage from the first half of the match. The default health is set to medium, and recovery time is set to long. Let's get this match back underway, where this time there will be a clear winner.
It'll be these two.
And there's the bell. This match has resumed.
Tonight.
Master and Zims, once again, the legal men.
And aggressive at the same time.
Or sorry, Master and Danger, rather.
Don't see every day.
And Danger forces Master into the corner, and the referee
right now
breaks them up, but then Danger does the same thing once again. And surprisingly, no cheap shots for either man. But now Danger, once again, has Master right back in that corner and connects the attack. Now Danger forced back up to his feet. DDT from Danger. See Master still exhausted from the first half of the match. There's an Irish rip and an elbow.
God, face first.
Now Master forced back up to his feet. Irish rip into the corner.
Yeah, looks absolutely out of it, Cole.
Master biding his time, but now forces Danger up and slams him into another corner, and now right back to the original corner.
Elusive movement.
There's a reversal by Danger with a series of leg kicks.
Reversal there.
In a tag team contest, a superstar and
Master now forced into the Generation's corner, but is able to get out and connect with a massive backbreaker. Master's head already back in the yellow zone, but now he taunts his opponents. There's an Irish trip into the ropes and a knee to the gut of Danger, and another. And a Russian leg sweep. Master looking to make quick work of the Generation, well, at least in the second half of this matchup, but Danger powers out at one.
You build momentum.
Now Danger forcing to the Legion's corner. In comes Zims.
When they step in the ring.
But first it's a double team attack and a double backstabber. Now Danger trying to force Zims into the Generation's corner and does. But Zims is able to quickly get out. There's an Irish Whip into the ropes. And a swinging neck breaker from Danger. Danger's body in the yellow zone now as well, already getting injured all over again. Danger looking to pick up the victory for the Generation, but Zims powers out immediately and Danger is in shock. Zims misses with the kick and that allows Danger an opening to lawn dart him into the top turnbuckle in the Generation's corner.
He's getting absolutely trounced right now, guys.
And Zim's able to catch the leg during the roundhouse and go back on the attack. Submission locked in by Zims. Targeting the legs and arm of Danger, but he's able to quickly break the hold. Reversal by Danger. Danger very close to having a signature maneuver in his arsenal and connects with an enziguri. And now both team will make a tag, a mercy tag for the Legion to bring in Aeot Master. And a regular tag for the Generation. And Matt Olsen is going for a move we're pretty familiar with. The, as J.K. of the Blood Brothers calls it, three Union Amigos. A regular term is the Three Amigos. Matt Olsen, who is the only man, as just like in the first half of this matchup, without any sort of damage to him whatsoever, if you look at the HUD, connects with his signature maneuver. He calls the 618, and that connects. Olsen goes for cover and nearly scores a victory for the Generation in the night of his WWE debut, but Master powers out at two. Matt Olsen looking impressive on the night of his debut. He would love to walk away with a victory over a dominant stable from the main roster. Master misses with a clothesline. But Olsen misses with the enziguri, and that allows Master another opportunity to go on the attack, who headbutts Olsen. Master does have a signature maneuver in his arsenal, and he's going to use it right away. Death kick connects. Master goes for cover. And Olsen powers out at 1.5. Master is in shock. Choke slam by Master attempted, but reversed by Olsen, who has a finisher of his own. Now Master sent into the Generation's corner, and Aaron Danger, once again, the legal man. Right now it is the Generation in control here in the second half of this matchup. Master has a body in the yellow zone and head in the orange zone, and yet still is able to power out at 1.5. Connects with the Danger kick. Master's head is in the red zone, in danger of injury now. Very, very nearly a victory for the Generation, but Zims is there to make the save at 2.5 to keep this match alive for the Legion, who was nearly upset in this matchup. The Legion have never suffered a clean loss since forming officially as a stable. And that nearly changed as Danger gets a near fall as well at 2.5. Danger getting fired up. He can smell victory for the Generation and revenge for himself.
One on hook.
DDT connects. Master in a bad way and desperately needs to get over to Zims. He's crawling towards his corner trying to do that, but just as he was about to lunge for the tag, Danger is able to break it up. And Danger, he is very much fired up, and the NXT Universe is loving it. Danger goes for a super kick that's going to be evaded by Master, who forces Danger into the Legion corner and makes that much needed tag to Zims, and they first connect with a double backstabber. Zims goes for the cover. Is he going to pin his former leader? No, Danger pars out at two. Zims forces Danger up. And the signature maneuver connects that he calls Death Toll. Zims goes for cover. Danger powers out at 2.5. Yet another near fall. Combining the first and second half of these matches, what a great tag team war. And Zims has busted open Aaron Danger, his former leader. Goes for cover. Olsen makes a mad dash into the ring to break it up. Yet another near fall. This, forget NXT TakeOver, this is a WrestleMania quality tag team war we have going on. Zims connects with the diving elbow drop. As he does, Danger still makes the emergency tag to Matt Olsen, who has no injury whatsoever, and immediately connects with the Three Amigos. Olsen, I think he's trying to make a tag, but doesn't realize that Danger's not there for the tag. So now he chooses to just taunt his opponent as Zims very slowly starts to stir. Olsen heads to the top rope. And that connects. And Zims powers out at two. Zims rolls out of the way to avoid the stomp, but Olsen's right back in the attack with yet another Three Amigos. As Olsen is getting fired up, Danger returns to the apron. Zims with a reversal. And connects with a suplex. Now Olsen forced up to his feet. Reversal by Olsen. And you guessed it, Three Amigos from Matt Olsen. Zims now in danger of injury once again with his body in the red zone. Olsen pretty much just telling Zims to bring it. Olsen very impressive on the night of his debut, win or lose. Olsen again seeking the support of the NXT Universe. I think he is already starting to become a fan favorite here for the NXT faithful. Now Zims forced up to his feet. Reversal by Zims, who desperately needs to get on the attack here. It has been all generation for pretty much the entire second half of this matchup. And both members of the Legion that are in this matchup are in danger of injury. That would be catastrophic to the Legion to lose one of their members to injury with that huge matchup backlash taking place in just 1 week. Winner take all for the Universal and SmackDown tag titles. At this rate, it might be Corey versus both Strowman and Casey.
Needs to make it to the corner here, Corey. Oh, you're absolutely right, Corey. There's no way around it. The tag is vital at this point in the match.
Zims trying to do just that and get back on the attack. It connects with a suplex, but Olsen kips up and gets right back on his feet. I believe Olsen might be trying to set up for another 6-1-8. But now Zims returns the favor and lands on his feet. Suplex connects. Zims kips up yet again. There's an Irish Whip into the Generation corner. And Danger, now the legal man for the Generation. And first a double team attack. Danger goes for cover. and The Generation in their final match as a stable score a huge upset victory over the Legion, handing the Legion their first ever loss as a stable. Danger gets his revenge here at TakeOver.
Pushing harder, the water's all around.
Okay, well, what a way to send off the Generation. Aaron Danger gets his revenge in a huge way, pinning the man who turned his back on him and the Generation, Zims, in his final match as leader of the Generation. Matt Olson also pick up a victory over in his first match on the NXT roster, first match in the WWE. Meanwhile, for the Legion, they take a loss at the worst possible time a week before that huge winner-takes-all match at Backlash, where their SmackDown tag team titles will be on the line as they try to gain the Universal title. The Legion have now suffered their first clean loss as a stable, and Corey, who was forced to stand ringside at watch, ringside and watch as it happened, I'm sure is not going to be very happy. We'll have to hear what he says on the next edition of SmackDown. They go home SmackDown before Backlash. But now we turn our attention to our first of two title matches on this card. Andrew Spudstrong, in the midst of his incredible 7th NXT Cruiserweight Championship reign, returns to the ring for his first match in Season 6 and defends against the man who went undefeated in the tournament to crown the number one contender to the Cruiserweight title, Isaiah Swerve Scott. As we did before, we're going to have a short hype video recapping some of the storyline elements that led to this matchup, and then we will get into the entrances and the match. Let's get to it. During the WWE offseason, I got to thinking that since I did promise to give opportunities to up-and-coming talent, maybe it is time I limit my own time in the spotlight. So, for now, I'm going to step back and let the rest of the Cruiserweights get this new era of the NXT Cruiserweight division underway. 8 of them will be featured in a tournament, until only one remains, and that is when I'll make my in-ring return to put my NXT Cruiserweight title on the line against the winner of the tournament. Best of luck, Cruiserweights. He's the very dominant Andrew. There's a neck breaker from Scott. Scott has been successful with aerial maneuvers so far, so he's going for it again. Looked like a variation of the coup de grace, and that is going to put Geralt away. Both these men put up a heck of a fight, but Isaiah Swerve Scott is the man that will face Andrew at TakeOver In Your House for the Cruiserweight title. Gerald put up an amazing run, but he is eliminated at 3-2. And with a new era in Cruiserweight wrestling comes new, young, and hungry challengers looking to take my place as the face of the Cruiserweight division. Such as my opponent this Sunday at TakeOver, the winner of the number one contenders tournament, Isaiah Swerve Scott. Now this past Wednesday on NXT, I tried to offer him some encouragement and advice, and all he did was give me the silent treatment. So this Sunday at TakeOver In Your House, with my title on the line, I'm going to give him a new lesson. A lesson in respect. Andrew, I do respect you. And I'm fully aware of everything that you've done here and the fact that Cruiserweight Wrestling likely wouldn't exist in the WWE anymore were it not for you. That said, while you've been off cycling and eating potatoes for the past few months, I've been on NXT and 205 Live, defeating every challenger who has come my way. And this Sunday, I'm going to continue riding this hot streak and swerve right into that NXT Cruiserweight title match and leave as the new Cruiserweight champion. Well then, you've finally talked the talk, and soon we'll find out if you can walk the walk. I look forward to facing you this Sunday.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the NXT Cruiserweight Championship.
Is foiled.
Man.
Elbow drop.
Woo. Well measured.
Look at this. Oh, my goodness.
Jam your leg in a bad way.
Okay, well, apparently no entrance needed for the returning Andrew Spudstrong, going right after Isaiah Scott during his entrance on the entrance ramp. Andrew apparently took it personally when Isaiah didn't give him the silent treatment when he tried to give him advice on NXT just a few days ago. And so not giving Scott an opportunity to make an entrance to this matchup, sacrificing his own entrance to go right after Isaiah Scott here. Now they're finally in the ring and this match is officially underway. Scott didn't get an opportunity to take off his entrance jacket. Andrew with a massive DDT to the head of Scott, now taunting him. As we get a shot of the NXT faithful, and Scott has got an opportunity to take off his jacket. And now this match has resumed. Andrew, you can see with the HUD already with an advantage thanks to that entrance attack. But now Scott trying to get back on the attack. He was incredible during the number one contenders tournament for the right to get this Cruiserweight title matchup. Running the gauntlet and going undefeated on his way to this matchup. He is, however, coming off a loss on 205 Live. So I have to see how that affects Scott. Andrew, of course, you're talking about the most successful WITA member, seven-time Cruiserweight champion in his seventh reign right now, as well as a former Universal Champion, former WWE Champion, former ECW Champion, former Royal Rumble winner, former COO of ECW, and former General Manager of 205 Live, among many other accomplishments. Will he be continuing his seventh Cruiserweight title reign tonight here on the night of his return, as the steel steps have a bit of a seizure with the lights or with the coloring? But anyway, and now they take the fight on to the outside as Andrew wants to bring the fight back inside. Isaiah actually has the advantage health-wise right now. Andrew's body is in the yellow zone, but now he's going after the legs of Scott. Andrew, a fantastic technical wrestler who loves to target the limbs of his opponents, and now locks in his signature maneuver, the rolling knee bar, causing Scott's legs to go into the yellow zone. Scott forced to his feet. Andrew may have been thinking flatline, but that's going to be reversed by Isaiah Scott.
Anticipated that attack perfectly.
Now there's an Irish Whip into the corner.
Here, guys. Downright treacherous.
Andrew turns him around and forces him on the outside. Rather than going for a flatline, Andrew is going to go through the ropes and connect with a massive DDT on the outside. That's going to send Isaiah Scott's head straight from no significant damage to the orange zone. Now Andrew going right back after those legs, trying to neutralize some of the speed and agility of Isaiah Scott, who somehow has two finishers stored up. If he can connect with both of those, we may have ourselves a new Cruiserweight champion, and he's going for the first one right now. Are we about to see a new Cruiserweight champion? No, Andrew powers out at two. Isaiah Scott in shock. He thought he had himself a Cruiserweight title, but now he's going for that other finisher. We see no time here. It connects a second time. The running kick to the head. Will this lead to a new Cruiserweight champion? Yes, Andrew's seventh Cruiserweight title reign comes to an end. His return is spoiled. We have a new Cruiserweight champion. It is Isaiah Swerve Scott.
Here is your winner and new W.
Good victory for him here in this one. Wow, the challenger simply refused to be denied. And now we are looking at a new champion. Unbelievable. Thanks for tuning in for this championship match. And what an amazing match it was.
Okay, well, that was definitely a surprising match, even after Andrew attacked him on the entrance ramp during his entrance. Isaiah Swerve Scott, in pretty easy fashion, defeated the 7-time Cruiserweight champion, Andrew Spudstrong, to become the new Cruiserweight champion, meaning he had a perfect tournament that led to a Cruiserweight championship for Isaiah Swerve Scott. How will Andrew recover? That is, I'm sure, definitely not the return he envisioned. Maybe taking all that time off outside the ring was a bad idea, as it led to him losing his title in just minutes, even with an entrance attack. But now we turn our attention to our main event of the evening and final match of the episode. A rivalry coming to an end, and for one of these women, they're talking about NXT coming to an end, as not only is the NXT women's title on the line, but the loser must leave NXT for good. It's Rose defending her NXT women's title against the Queen, Charlotte Flair, and this will be a no-holds-barred match after these two women went to a double countout in their title match on NXT last week. There now must be a winner here at TakeOver. Once again, we are going to show a hype video that shows some of the storyline build up to this matchup, and then we will get into the entrances and the match. Rose, I told you 2 weeks ago that you're just not woman enough to be able to step up to the Queen and win. And then, of course, I proceeded to toss you around like a rag doll and make the easiest ascension to the number one contendership of a women's title that I've ever had. Rose, take some advice from the Queen. Hand me that NXT women's title, walk away, and learn to stay in your lane, little girl. You know what, Charlotte? I actually agree with some of what you said. After all, I'm not tall and muscular like you, and I wasn't born into wrestling like you were. I am, compared to you, a little girl. But I am a little girl with a dream. A dream of kicking your beep, shutting you the beep up, and leaving the Performance Center tonight still the NXT Women's Champion. In the Generation, Aaron Danger. There's a kick to the gut of Rose from Charlotte as they continue to find the outside. Rose sent near the steel steps. Charlotte comes in at about 9. Does she break the count? No, she does not. Not win the title. What does this mean for the NXT Women's title and the careers of these two women? Ladies, had to make things complicated for me, didn't you? Luckily for you two, I have the solution. Unfortunately, tonight's broadcast is about to end. So, at NXT TakeOver In Your House, we will have a rematch. It will be Rose defending her NXT Women's Championship against Charlotte Flair in a loser leaves NXT matchup. But this time, there must be a winner. So this match will be no disqualification, no count out, falls count anywhere. And that also means no Ric Flair, no Aaron Danger. Just the two of you ladies fighting for the NXT Women's title and your time in NXT. To continue, best of luck to you both. We'll see you on pay-per-view.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the NXT Women's Championship.
Introducing the champion from Chicago, Illinois, she is the NXT Women's Champion, the Queen, Rose.
It's all about the NXT Women's Championship. Everyone who has held that title has gone on to create massive waves.
And there is the prize on the line, the prize that both these women are putting their NXT futures on the line for, the NXT Women's Championship. Rose has earned that title very early on in her WWE career. Meanwhile, Charlotte Flair already has a very impressive resume, including several Raw and SmackDown Women's Championship, but she wants more. She wants to add the NXT Women's title to that collection, as she has done in real life. Can she do so here in Rose's reign and time on NXT? Charlotte has Rose in the corner and hits a series of elbow strikes, but Rose is able to get out with a kick to the gut and a crossbody. There is a kick to the back. This is a no-holds-barred matchup. Last time these two women faced each other 2 weeks ago on NXT, it was a regular singles match, and they spent 90% of the match brawling on the outside, which eventually led to a victory via countout for Charlotte Flair, but did not lead her to a title victory because the match ended via countout, and so Stephanie McMahon decided to have this match redone here at TakeOver, but this time there will be a clear winner because there are no disqualifications, no countouts. Right now, Rose with the advantage early on. She already has Charlotte's body into the yellow zone and has much more momentum than she does. But here comes Charlotte trying to swing momentum into her favor. Now Rose forced up to her feet. It's already was a good night for the men of the generation. Their final night as a stable will it end as a perfect night for the now former stable known as the Generation, with Rose leaving TakeOver still the women's champion and still part of NXT. There is an elbow strike to the back from Charlotte, but here comes Rose with an Irish whip into the corner. How huge would it be for Rose to defeat a challenger the caliber of Charlotte Flair? She goes for cover. Does she remain champion? She nearly does, but Charlotte powers out at two, and Rose is in shock. Now Charlotte sent into the ropes. Rose went for a headbutt, but mid-headbutt was kneed in the head by Charlotte, who connects with a chop in the style of her legendary father, Ric Flair. There's a crossbody from Rose, who has a signature maneuver built up. And she's going to use it right away. The twist of Rose connects, sending Charlotte's body into the orange zone. Does Rose remain champion? No, still that's not enough. Charlotte powers out at two, and Rose is in shock. Charlotte again forced to her feet. And now Rose goes for cover after using her finisher. Does she remain champion? No. How much punishment is Charlotte going to need to take to stay down? Charlotte, you can see health-wise, in a bad way. Rose with a massive advantage. Okay, now not as much, as Charlotte connects with a spear and goes for cover. Do we have a new women's champion? No, it's another near fall, this time for Charlotte, as Rose powers out at two. And now it's Charlotte asking herself what she must do to win this title. And now she locks in the figure four, the move patented by her father, Ric Flair. Is it going to lead her to an NXT Women's Championship, adding to her already incredible resume? It is locked in well. Nowhere to go for Rose. She must break the hold. And the hold is broken, but how much damage has been done already? And now Charlotte, showing shades of her legendary father with the Ric Flair strut, and now going for a comeback sequence. She wants another signature maneuver, and she'll get it, as Rose's body is now in the orange zone. A believe Rose was going for her comeback sequence, but that was broken up by Charlotte, who connects with a second spear. Charlotte goes for cover and becomes the NXT Women's Champion. Rose will no longer compete on NXT. She must now try to move up to either Raw or SmackDown, but her time on NXT and time as NXT Women's Champion comes to an end. Charlotte is your new NXT Women's Champion. Okay, and here is your results and rankings update for this edition of NXT TakeOver In Your House. And their final match ever as a stable, the Generation had the best send-off they possibly could have, defeating the up-to-this-point dominant Legion of SmackDown Live, with Aaron Danger pinning the former Generation member who turned his back on the Generation to join the Legion, Zims, in the process. Then we had a huge upset with Isaiah Swerve Scott fending off Andrew Spudstrong to become the new NXT Cruiserweight Champion in just minutes, even after Andrew attacked him during his entrance. We have new NXT Tag Team Champions as Imperium defeated the Forgotten Sons, ending the Forgotten Sons' time on NXT for good, and they're currently inactive on SmackDown as well, so it might be a while before we see the Forgotten Sons again. We have a new NXT North American Champion. Dexter defeated Kushida to become the new North American Champion. Johnny Gargano retained the NXT Championship over Adam Cole. And we have a new NXT Women's Champion. Charlotte Flair defeated Rose in a good back and forth matchup to add the NXT Women's Championship to already incredible resume. Rose is no longer part of NXT, but will now return to Monday Night Raw, where she already had a match against Nia Jax, Money in the Bank qualifiers. And how does this affect the rankings on NXT? Let's find out. Starting off with the women's tag team titles, the champions are Sasha and Bayley. Number one contenders, Alexa Bliss and Nikki Cross. Number two, Natalya and Lana. Number three, The Iconics. Number four, Shotzi Blackheart and Tegan Knox. The NXT Cruiserweight Champion is Isaiah Swerve Scott. Number one contender, Tony Nese. Number two, Jake Atlas. Number three, Gerald. Number four, Akira Tozawa. Number five, WITM's Austin Rage. Number six, the man formerly known as El Hijo del Fantasma, now unmasked and known as Santos Escobar. Number seven, Mansoor, moving over from the North America Title Division to the Cruiserweight Division, seeing as he competed on 205 Live on Real Life last week. Andrew Spudstrong finds himself in a very unfamiliar spot. He's usually either champion or the number one contender to a title. He now finds himself at number eight and must rack up some wins and climb up seven spots in order to try to earn a rematch against Isaiah Scott and his eighth Cruiserweight title reign. Number 9 is Brian Kendrick, and number 10, Oney Lorcan. The NXT Women's Champion is Charlotte Flair. Number contender, Io Shirai. Number 2, Mia Yim. Number 3, Rhea Ripley. Number 4, Casey Catanzaro. Number 5, Candice LeRae. Number 6, Aaliyah. Number 7, Caden Carter. Number 8, Mercedes Martinez. Number 9, Vanessa Bourne. Number 10, Xia Li. And number 11, Dakota Kai. The NXT Tag Team Champions are Imperium. Number contenders, Indy Shear. Number 2, Breezango. Number 3, The Undisputed Era. Number 4, a newly downloaded team that's been competing on NXT and 205 Live in real life, Ever-Rise, Chase Parker, and Matt Martell. The North American champion is Dexter Lumis, we have ourselves an interesting situation because the two now former tag team partners in the generation are the top two contenders to the North American title. Number one, Aaron Danger, the former leader. And number two, the man who just made his debut in a winning effort, Matt Olson. So they might go straight from tag team partners to rivals over a North American title shot. Number three is Cameron Grimes. Number four, Damian Priest. Number five, Dominik Dijakovic. Number six, Killian Dane. Number seven, Kushida. And number eight, Timothy Thatcher. The NXT champion is Johnny Gargano. Number contender, Adam Cole. Number two, Finn Balor. Number three, Tommaso Ciampa. Number four, Keith Lee. And number five, Karrion Kross. So that does it for NXT TakeOver In Your House. Now we'll move on to Monday Night Raw and see if the Bank Robbers, JKs, and the returning to Raw, now fully exclusive to Raw, Rose, are in action. Okay, and we do indeed have a stacked card for the go-home edition of Monday Night Raw before Backlash in 6 Universe Days, our next pay-per-view. First, you'll see one half of the Blood Brothers, JKs, being accompanied by his tag team partner, who is still currently recovering from injury, Dillon Hayes, taking on Ricochet, accompanied by his tag team partner, Cedric Alexander, in singles action. Then we have the Raw Tag Team Champions, the Bank Robbers, in non-title action. They're going to be taking on the Viking Raiders. And then, last but not least, we have what should be a really good 24/7 title defense by Ayat, Master of the Legion. He'll be taking on a man that who inspires a lot of his move sets and characteristics, and whose entrance he's copied, Aleister Black, in a 24/7 title match. That should definitely be a good one. Three good matches for you on a stacked Raw card in episode number 24. But that is going to do it for episode number 23. If you enjoyed it, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss a single moment of WITM action. If you're watching via our Facebook page, be sure to like the post, like the page, and perhaps leave a comment. If you'd like to join WITM with your own custom Ka, if you have WWE 2K20 on PS4, you can upload your characters to community creations with the hashtag WITM. Or if you do not have the game, you can head to the link in the description for our WITM website and fill out all the necessary information there. And when we're able to, we will make a call for you. And either way, we will get back to you as soon as possible after your submission. But that does it for episode number 23 and episode number 24. JK's with Dillon Hayes versus Ricochet with Cedric Alexander in rare singles action for these two teams. Then the Raw Tag Team Champions, the Bank Robbers, in non-title action versus the Viking Raiders. And Ayat Master defends the 24/7 title for the second week in a row versus Aleister Black. Until then, this is Corey with WITM Ka Wrestling, signing off.